Hi, this is Dave Hodges from the Common Sense Show, where we're freeing America one enslaved mind at a time. And you're listening to the Red List News. And Red List News is brought to you by Numana.com/Hodges for the best tasting storable food, the best priced storable food, in making sure that your family is prepared in this time of uncertainty. Go to Numana.com/Hodges. Also want to tell you about healthmasters.com, where my good friend Dr. Ted Brower has managed yours truly out of three health crises in the last couple of years. And Dr. Ted has done the same for people like Doug Hagman. I use Health Masters as my pharmacy. I don't take pharmaceuticals any longer. I'm simply going natural. And I'll tell you, my health has improved exponentially. And for a limited time only, Common Sense Show and Red List News listeners can take 5% off their total purchase price. Simply put in the coupon code DAVE5. So for all of your natural health care needs, go to healthmasters.com and put in the coupon code DAVE5 to take 5% off your purchase price. Well, today on the Red List News, I think we would entitle this, "A Rose is a Rose is a Rose by Any Other Name. Globalism Through the United Nations Agenda 21. It's morphed into Agenda 2030, and now it's called Vision 2050. Yeah, you believe that? They've got a new name already. And what they're trying to do is confuse the public with these different names, because as soon as you can latch on to Agenda 21, oh yeah, we've heard what that means, and we don't like it because it means the removal of all energy from our life. Well, that's only part of the picture. When we look at the climate change industry, their entire goal is to privatize all energy and put energy through the power of government under the control of a few corporations. Basically, this is going to be the biggest wealth redistribution scheme in all of world history. Absolutely phenomenal what's happening right now. And they have a new name for it. The process in which they're going to use to take your money and take it out of your pockets to pay exorbitant fees for the same amount of energy that you're using today actually has a term. A noble sounding term. It's called environmental justice. Now, you know, here's what's interesting. I remember being in the 10th grade and taking a world history class, and I learned that in feudalism, most of the people who were serfs, and that was about 90 to 95% of the population at that time, they didn't travel more than 10, 12 miles from their home. No, they didn't. Well, we're facing the same thing today. When Agenda 2030, now morphing into Vision 2050, comes into play, they are going to make it impossible for the vast majority of people to travel, and your mobility will represent a serf from the Middle Ages. Let me give you a few examples here. The CEOs, the 14 CEOs that have made up these protocols, and they decide what constitutes global sustainability without consulting you, here's what they have determined. They want to incorporate the cost of externalities, starting with carbon, ecosystem services, and water into the structure of the marketplace. In other words, they're taking control of the pricing and they're going to charge what they darn well want. They want to double agricultural output without increasing the amount of land or water used. That's like saying we're going to remove darkness without turning on the light. That's not going to happen. What they're basically setting the world up for there in this situation here is to basically control people through food. This practice, if you have a growing population, no matter how slight, you have to put more water into your efforts. But they're not going to. Well, this is going to cause food shortages. And the food, I guarantee you, will be used to manipulate compliance when the people begin to rebel. They say they want to halt deforestation and increasing the yields from planted forests. No, they don't. The pharmaceuticals are raping the forests right now. You know, particularly in areas where pharmaceuticals and natural medicines come from, these forests are disappearing because of the corporate ravaging. And it's the same corporations that are trying to force this pseudo-sustainability upon us. They want to cut in half carbon emissions worldwide. Cut in half. Can you imagine your life without half of the energy that you use? Can you imagine what your life would be like? Try practicing that just for an afternoon. Cut your energy use in half. It's amazing, isn't it? And they also want to have this, what they call low carbon mobility. And this is where they're going to turn you into an immobile traveling serf. What they want to do is to tax you every time you want to go somewhere. Like the old Soviet Union, they're going to put up these grid checkpoints. But in the Soviet Union, they did it to keep revolutionaries from coalescing together and starting an overthrow of the government during the Soviet era. So they used to have these guard towers about every 20 miles. Well, they want to do the same thing here, only they want more guard towers and they want them closer together. And the purpose is not necessarily to prevent revolution, although that'll be one of the effects when you limit mobility, but they just simply want to keep you from traveling. And every time you cross a checkpoint, they want to throw a tax at you. And they actually have a term now for your city that will adopt these practices. And you're going to be hearing this a lot from the climate change people. Get ready. Get ready, because I suspect when Hillary Clinton starts spouting in her campaign, the earth is going to die, the ice caps are melting, and the polar bears are treading water and trying to fight to survive, she's going to start using this term, a low-carbon mobility city. Low-carbon mobility city. And this is where we get back into the stack-and-pack cities. Stack-and-packs. Do you know what those are? It's a plan that came out of an advisor of President Obama, and he is responsible for something called America2050.org. Really interesting website if you go there and look at it. And they talk about America Stack and Pack. And what that means is high density housing and no mobility. Because everything will be within walking range. Everything from your work to your medical services to your recreation to your living quarters. And they want to have, and we're already seeing this happen in large cities now, they want to have what's called these micro apartments. Micro apartments are defined as a living structure less than 500 or even less than 250 square feet. We see entire areas now of New York City that are dedicated to the tiny house, tiny apartment concept. And we see the same thing in San Francisco, what they call Bay Area 1. But even in a mid-sized city like Fort Collins, Colorado, population 140,000, they have the same thing. Yes, that's right. This is Agenda 21. Into the modern era, gone crazy. This is absolutely nuts. And their master plan is this, and I'm going to leave you with a riddle. They want to have, according to America 2050, 11 megacities, all consisting of 6 million people each. Let's do the math. 11 times 6, that's 66 million people. And the American population is well over 300 million. Can someone answer this question for me? By the year 2050, when we're down to 66 million people, where will the other 250 million Americans have gone? We're going to have more on this in the next edition of the Red List News. This is frightening where this is headed. Absolutely frightening. I want to thank you for joining us here on the Red List News, and we'll be back in a short while with part two in this series, Where Have the People Gone? Because this is not the only instance where your population by 2050 is projected to be 250 million people. Remember, we're sponsored by Numana.com/Hodges for the very best in your storable food needs, and also healthmasters.com. Coupon code DAVE5 to save 5% on all purchase prices. And don't forget, our YouTube channel is going crazy. Please become a part of it. Please check out the interviews that we're accumulating there, and simply go to thecommonsenseshow.com main page, click on the YouTube icon, and go there. Don't forget to subscribe and to like us. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you back here soon.